Here we are with Westgate's new Pro Model, featuring one of the photos I took for In the Streets series. This is the back of City Hall. Always really admired all the architecture all throughout all of downtown, so I wanted to really feature this piece.
Shooting everything at night, there's no people, especially at the hours that I was going out. So like no one was really out. All I was ever catching was like the traffic and everything, which I thought was pretty cool. A lot of the locations I picked, you couldn't really place like a time period on it. So like you don't know if it was like 20 years ago or whatever. Like everything's kind of like somewhat nostalgic, I guess. The whole series kind of developed just me going out and experimenting with the camera, just trying to really get a feel for it. I didn't really go out with the intention of shooting a board series at first, you know? Just kind of developed and grew from there. Skating New York City, as cliche as it is to say, it's probably the best feeling. I've skated in a couple like different cities throughout the US and also over in Asia, and nothing compares to New York, just like going down the streets or whatever. Every day, just walk out of my house and start cruising. So won't you lie? Pretty psyched on everything came out. Big thanks to New York, Chapman.
It's pretty crazy to know that like my name's gonna be on a board. I don't know, just cause definitely not going pro for skating. So if I can go pro for shooting photos, that's even better. Tribe Called Quest, represent. When the mic is in my hand, I'm never hesitant. My favorite jam back in the day was Eric B for president.
Hey, what's up, everybody? We're at my crib in Astoria, New York City. Lived in this apartment all my life. Yeah, I usually take the train like every day. It takes about like 45 minutes, but I'm in the city usually every day. My homie actually had a skateboard. Like, he used to live on the third floor in this building. Like, I would like go outside and like share this dude's skateboard. I'd be like, yo, let me try. All right, like, dude, I did it for like months. I finally got like a mongoose or something, like a mongoose board. Totally flat, like cheapest plastic trucks ever. They sucked. And then I fucking finally got a real board from a garage sale for $4. It was just like a real board. It was like, I think, an Alien Workshop or something. I still have it, by the way. And I still have the mongoose trucks on it. I guess the thing I like the most about skating in New York is you can do whatever you personally want to do. You know, if I don't want to see someone, I'll go left, you know? Like, if I want to skate that spot, I'll go right, you know? My homie had, like, the TM's email for Zoo. Basically, just, like, emailed him out of left field. I was like, yo, like, take my footage, please. Like, I have, like, one board a month. He didn't get back to me for a while. And then I seen Zared at, like, some mini-ramp party. He came up to me and was like, yo, like, seeing your footage, like, he was like, told me I was gonna start getting boards from Zoo. I was just like, holy shit, like, I got on Zoo, like, I'm getting boards. You know, it was pretty crazy.
Assassin, I can fleas off his collar. Hip hop scholar, since being the hot to a duck. The height of Muggsy Bogues, complexion of a hockey puck. You better ask somebody on how we flip the script. Come to a tribe show and watch the three kids rip. Reasons in the house, represent, zen. A Tribe Called Quest, represent, zen. No team in local style, cause they get to reverent. A Tribe Called Quest, represent, zen. Here we go. You know that I'm the rebel.
Bit nippy out. But we're still gonna skate. And we're gonna check out Astoria Park. It's about 2 blocks away from my house. I think we're meeting Westgate over there, so that should be cool.
Yeah, it's my local park. I live like 2 blocks away. Pretty tight. We got Westgate.
Astoria Park, baby. The house represent, zen. A Tribe Called Quest, represent, zen. No team in local style, cause they get to reverent. A Tribe Called Quest, represent, zen. Here we go. You know that I'm the rebel. Throwing out the wicked like God did the devil. Funky like your grandpa's drawers. Don't test me, we in like that.
You're dead like Presley. When we come and through, get tickets to see me. We work for the paper, so there'll never be a preemie. Lyrics are abundant, cause we got it by the mass. Egos are our idol, cause the music is the jazz. Fingers will up on the pitch. Curveball, catch it. I think I got it locked. Just move while I latch it. Right, right. Now I must move with the quickness. Here comes Shahid, so we must bear the witness. The dog is scientific with the styles I invent. A drop for quest, represent, represent.
Just had a great session at Astoria Park. Now we're here at Flushing Meadow Park, one of the most famous Queen skate spots. I'm sure you've seen it. Mad videos. Pretty dope. Been coming here since I was like 12 years old.
But here's my proposition. I let my lyrics flow and jump your whole position. I'm radical with this, like the man as long as after. Tip, settle down. What's the reason for the laughter? I really can't say. I guess I'll have to keep it crying. So much going on, people killing people.
Alright, you guys got to see my crib. Skated Astoria Park. Westgate came through. Went to Flushing. Got frozen. Now I'm gonna go back to my crib. Stay warm. About to get dark out. Stay tuned for the next zoo video. Later, y'all.
A lot of skaters around. Luckily, they just built this skate park over here by the Yankee Stadium, which is definitely great. It's a good location, got a lot of like small, mellow stuff to skate. It's real fun. Just had a fun sesh, just linked up with the homies. Now we're gonna go grab a bite to eat over by Yankee Stadium. We're here in New York City's Bodega. It's a great establishment where you can just get a sandwich, put anything you want on it, cheese, lettuce, tomatoes, just go all out. Just pile it real high, it's good. Let's grab some. That's it for the Bronx. Now we're about to head downtown where I do a lot more of my skating. Hit up Supreme, hit some spots, let's do it.
I'ma shine, and I'ma work how I work, move how I move, do what I do, it's me and my crew, always on mine, I'm on my grind, all of the time, yeah I'ma shine, you see me, yeah I'ma shine, black day shining all of the time.
How I got into skating is a homie of mine that lived in my apartment complex growing up and always saw him skate. I asked him to borrow his board and he was always doing slappy no slides, and then I was fucking slappy no slides were tight. I was like, I'm backing this. I got on Zoo. The current team manager, Ben, hit me up. He gave me a call and asked me what was up because I was currently riding for a different company. And he just let me know what was up, and I felt blessed to get that opportunity. You know, New York has so much history behind it.
Work how I work, I work, shine how I shine, I shine, skate how I skate, skate, grind how I grind. Ching, ching. Your money late, my money always on time. And there's no mistake, no boy, I'm not lying. And this shit all day, homie, I'm gonna get mine. Get me. I said fuck the law, but this ain't no crime. I'm high as the clouds, nigga, I feel like I'm flying. My card is accepted, but homie, your card declined. But please don't neglect that, these tracks I be wrecking.
Getting into music, it just started as something that I did for fun. I always have been a big fan of rap music and filming my own videos, directing my own videos. So one day I just recorded a song, it was pretty good, and got on World Star Hip Hop and everyone was really psyched on it. I just did it kind of as a joke in a way, just to show people another side to me. I like it because I can relay any type of message I want. Like, I can put out a song just to have fun to and party to, or I can put out a song where I really wanna, you know, send a strong message. So you guys got to see a glimpse of my life. Started in the Bronx, went to the new skate park, got some clips, linked up with some homies, went downtown, skated a couple spots around there, hit Supreme, and now we're about to gear up for the show tonight at Santos Party House.
Shout out my New Yorkers in this motherfucker! Everybody in this bitch from London! All my niggas from Supreme up in this bitch, we turning this up. Yeah. I need me know my niggas are bouncing this shit. Kill, 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 kill. Oh, motherfucker, we gon' ride. Said we gon' ride. Ride. Motherfucker, we gon' ride. What we gon' do? Skate hard.
Wanna see it? Come on, let's check it out.
Skate around New York a bunch, and I was kind of limited because I was hurt like the whole time we were filming. So I think I only took like 2 trips out here and just tried to get the most of what I could. But it was fun while it lasted, and I'm excited to see it.
In itself, to have an established East Coast company is very important. You know, whoever it be, just because we don't really have much back in the day, you know? And there's still, I mean, there is now because you have the World Wide Web, but back then you barely, you know, no one could afford these cameras back in the day, and you didn't, there was no outlet. So, you know, for someone to start something back then was significant in its own way, just to have it here in the city, and obviously for the people who did follow skating, because, you know, they'll see people in magazines and stuff like that, and, you know, they're a rarity, too, to find at times. But to have a company out of New York, I think it only inspired more skaters to come out of the East Coast, at least in New York or just in the East Coast in general. So, I mean, overall, just the East Coast itself, I think it's important.
New York is just a really unique city. There's nothing really can compare to it. It's just the amount of energy and, like, cars driving around, crazy people you see. Like, every day is a different day, and the spots are always unique, always a little rough to skate, but they look super cool, and it's always a good time.
There's definitely a point when New York starts blowing up that you have to make that decision, you know. What horse are you going to bet on? What do we got? What do we got? And it was so exciting. Obviously, when everybody gets into this, we're all the same. Everybody wants to do their own brand. Everybody wants to do their own project. Everybody wants to be creative. How many skaters do you know that aren't artists?
They're all artists. It's everyone. The same thing. Art's just skating for your mind. So Quim Cardona, Jamal Williams, Josh Stewart, it's all
It's all art. Whether you dance, you sing, you can do anything, you know? So when we started off, you get to a point where you can only make so many skateboards in the little shop that you're set up, and then, you know, you wanted to make your own skateboards, but everyone's working on this project, and it's so exciting to be part of it. And the natural choice was just to say, this is what we're doing right now. And then I remember having certain brands that we were kind of like weaning ourselves off of, and I didn't want to let anybody down. Balbocito Screw Skateboards, we were like, hey, we'll show you how to print skateboards, man. We can't make your boards, and kind of like let them off softly. It was pretty exciting. It was a wild ride.
First time to the city, man, with a skateboard was crazy. Like, and I didn't understand like security guards existed. And I was skating these marble benches, and I was grinding them. Got kicked out of my first spot, and like my fucking heart was beating crazy. I'm like, oh my god, we're getting kicked out of this spot. Like, whatever. Getting kicked out of a spot got me into skating.
Just seeing like all the work that you've done, like, you know, it's like, I know like from having video parts, like the end result is like what you put in the whole time. So it's like, I don't want to get to the end, you know, worked all this time, get to the end, and then be disappointed. So I just try to stay motivated the whole time and just, I don't know, skate what I can and get what I can.
They say New York is what America was supposed to be, but the rest of America never figured out how to be. And that's what I learned from Eli Gesner my first day when he said, welcome to the team.
Wow. Working on this video was a lot of fun. You know, we shot it all in my favorite city to skateboard at, and that's New York City, here with the New York team. Shot entirely in New York City, which was a lot of fun, but also very hard because we didn't have a lot of choices on where to go. We were limited into where we could go. Everything had to be shot here. As most people know, it's not the easiest city to skate at, but to me, it's the funnest and it looks the greatest. So I had a great time, and just trying to keep the New York City vibe, you know, like kept it pretty low key production-wise, like just myself and the skaters, not like a full production team with Van and like.